All right, Autodesk Land, Alan here. You've been requested episode 5, directional blur, or actually just blur node in the map blend of modular gear. So here we go. I have something very simple, just a black frame, and then I'm creating essentially a black and white image of this diagonal line with the GMAS tracer. So that is going to be our input to modular gear. Now I tend to actually use modular gear through action, but I'm simplifying this and it's all the same result. So essentially, as our three inputs are front, back, and mat, it's all this diagonal line. Now let's say I wanted to do a directional blur on this. For the many purposes, I could list several. So this is what I want to do. If I wanted to do it in the front blend, it's pretty easy. I could take this blur node, throw it into the color blend, and set this to directional, and angle it up, and I could set my bias to 0, and we have this nice, soft, directionally blurred matte. If I wanted to do the same thing with the matte blend, so I'm going to duplicate this, I cannot put the blur node in the matte blend layer. I can only attach it here. Now, for very simple things, that's okay, right? But if I want to, I often do very complex, like I said in my previous video, I do very complex things in the modular gear. Some people think it's funky, wacky. Sometimes people really can't even understand what's going on. But modular gear, especially these matte blend layers and having both a color blend and a matte blend within modular gear within an action, can be very powerful to do very complex things in a compact and kind of single space. So while I can do this, as a very basic thing, if I wanted to combine that with other matte blend layers, I wouldn't be able to. And that's where the power is combining these multiple matte blend layers for different things. I can't really show them currently or publicly, but it would be very powerful. So my request is to allow the blur node to also go into the matte blend layers, not just the color blend layer. Of course, we do have our matte blur here. There we go. We do have our matte edge, but that doesn't have any directional blur or any of the other kind of nice blurs that we might have here. This is just a standard XY blur. So while it's nice for many purposes, it's not adequate for every purpose. So full blur node in the matte blend layer, in modular gear. You've been requested episode 5.